the conversation was about the security in the maritime sector. You will agree with us that there's an upsurge of insecurity, and it's become a bit alarming. I don't know how many of you remember that we had in 2016 or 17 secured an approval of both the president and the cabinet to introduce a maritime architecture, which is coming to fruition. The Israelis are about to launch, but let's not just use the word Israelis. They just provide training and equipment. The rest will be manned by the Nigerian security, the Navy leading, the police, the Air Force, the Army,
TSS.
The SSS. We thought that was the best way to go, even though it is within the domain of the Nigerian Navy. We wanted the other members of the armed forces to give them some support until we've completely arrested the situation before they can withdraw and allow Navy continue with the process. So we had to make that conversation because the shipping community is beginning to get a bit worried. And we didn't want them to take a decision that will affect our trade and other investment that has to do with maritime transportation. That's why we convened the meeting.
With due respect to the Honourable Minister, progress a bit on this briefing by telling us, did we have any existential threats, and how bad or how huge or how small that was, to the point that you now have to summon up this meeting that you had, and after the meeting, what essentially did you come up with? I think that would reduce the number of questions we may want to ask.
Even if we had it, you believe I should tell you. As a former governor, such things are kept within the listen of government so that you don't frighten people. The actual truth is that even if there were threats, they are not above the ability of government to handle it. But because those who do this, who do business in the water, are beginning to get a bit worried, you need to reassure them that we're on top of the situation. I like to quote those who say, don't be on top, please be under the situation so we can get it quickly done with. But the Nimasa is actually on top of the situation. And we believe that by the time we launch into the water, in a few months' time, if we don't eradicate insecurity, which is obviously not possible that you can completely eradicate it, but at least it will be reduced to its minimal base. That's what we think. Yes, sir.
So talking about the deep blue project, we'd like to know how much of the assets
have arrived.
Yes.
But that's a good question. We should have come with that document. I think let the MD of Nimasa answer that question. That's his business to tell us.
All right, thank you very much. The first is for me to correct the impression which the Honourable Minister has done earlier, but let me just further enhance that position. That we're not handing over our waterways to the Israelis to man. They are providing assets and the training and retraining of our armed forces, those who will man assets and man our waterways. Now, in terms of assets, 6 interceptor boats are in the country. The first special mission vessel came into the country December last year. The second special mission vessel will be in this country in February. The first special mission aircraft will be in the country before the end of the first quarter of this year. Then 6 armored vehicles are in the country already. Apart from 6 armored the first unmanned area vehicle will come in between now and the end of February. Then in terms of the helicopters, we expect the first helicopter in the first quarter of this year. Those are some of the assets that we have on ground. Recall that I mentioned that the first special mission vessel came in December last year. The second one will come in February, any time from now. Then in terms of the 6 armored personnel carriers, fitted with communication gadgets. Almost all the communication equipment are in the country already. Then I said to you, the first 6 interceptor boats are in the country. Then, of course, the personal gear to kit the dedicated forces are also in the country. Then the C4I center is fully operational. That's intelligence system is fully operational in Kirikiri. Those are some of the assets that are in the country. But between now and June, 80% of the assets will be in the country.
And will be manned by?
Nigerian military. Navy, Air Force, Police, Department of State Security Service, Nimasa.
Sir, I want a bit some clarification. It was like the end of this day. you mentioned the asset that are in the country and that it relates to trade in Nigeria. So I want to know, will all the assets arrive before trading commence?
No.
Has training commenced?
Training has commenced, yes. Now the training are in phases. The first set of training for CFI operators have been concluded. The intelligence officers course have also been concluded. Basic infantry training for soldiers who will fight on land around the littoral areas have been concluded. The soldiers are waiting to be deployed. What is holding them from being deployed is that they were waiting for these armored personnel carriers and the intervention personnel gear. Now, both are in the country. The first set of armored personnel carrier six are in the country. The gears are in the country. Then the ammunition and arms are also in the country. Now, apart from that, the first set of persons have been trained for maritime security units. The second set is what we will commence in the moment from now, the advanced maritime security training, which will take place in One, somewhere in another facility in River State. But there will be other trainings that will continue over time. The training for the intelligence officers to integrate what they do in the C4I Center with the special mission vessel, with special mission aircraft, with helicopters, and with the armored personnel carriers.
You must know that those who go to the water don't live inside the water. You agree to that? Because when the military start now going to the coastal states, you start saying the north hates the south. The south military officers from the north have come to the south to clean. These criminals live with us. Do we agree?
No.
I'm from the south. In case you don't know, my name is Chibike Rotimi. I'm from River State, so I come from the south. Okay. Now, because these criminals live with us, the military, both in terms of intelligence and in terms of physical assets, will go and comb them out. It is only when you, just like they did in Somalia. Now, see, Somalia is free.
Yes.
So when you comb them out, then there will be nobody going to the water. Look at the assets you're losing. We are paying a huge amount of money to protect the so-called surveillance.
Security.
I say surveillance first, we'll come to security courage. Surveillance. So an MPC is paying for what they call a surveillance contract. They escort white men first. Okay, well, vessels with white men to the platform. Right? So when you stop discipline, you are going to save a lot of money for the country. And when they start, I won't hear you say, if you like, you can say it as much as you want. North versus South, East versus West. It's your business. I won't care. Because the truth is that crime knows no
at all.
They don't, Amrabah don't come and say, stop. Where are you from first? Do they?
No.
Well, they ask your money or... They don't know whether you're from South or East or West or North, or you're a Christian or a Muslim. They're looking for what? Currency. So, clearly state it now that may likely happen when the soldiers are deployed. And instead of you attacking them, what you should do is to cooperate with them and support them so that we'll clean up this.
Honorable Minister, sir, sorry, my last question, sir. You invested in hardware and training of personnel and all that. Do you have any plan in your overall scheme to address the economic situation in the Niger Delta that drives insurgency and
You know the reply I want to give you. The reply I want to give you is that I'm not the minister for Niger Delta. But since your question is general in nature, maybe let me give it
tie
general. You shouldn't tie it to it. The issue is what I said today in the channel interview. The problem of insecurity is the problem of poverty.
Very true.
And hunger. And education. Whether it's in the north of Boko Haram or bandit, do the bandits stop you and say, are you Muslim or Christian? No, they're looking for you and I, the rich people. Because when we had money, what did we do? We did not invest in infrastructure that will grow the economy. So the economy is just there.
Absolutely.
The economy is just there. The economy is not able to create employment.
Absolutely.
So, like I say, if government is not able to provide legitimate means of livelihood for Nigerians, the poor Nigerian will provide for himself illegitimate means of
livelihood.
That's what's going on now.
Legitimate
so,
economy.
And when they knock on your door, say, please, I'm just an ordinary pawn. And I say, who are you? He say, maybe a politician. He say, not looking at your money or your life. It's our money or your life. That's what's going on. And what this does for you, however, is that when we save money for the country, I hope that money will be invested, continue to be invested in infrastructure, just like the president is doing now. The more infrastructure you create, the more industrial development you create. The more industrial development you create, the more employment you create. As many people as possible that you employ, so would you reduce the number of crimes that take place. Let me quote myself. I have always said as a governor that if all of us are working in Shell, Would there be time to kidnap? Tell me time now. You wake up at 6 a.m., take your bath by 7, you're in the office. You leave office at 7. By the time you get home, what do you do? Sleep. I have a friend whose wife was always worrying him. I said, bring him, bring her. Once we gave her employment, when she comes back, she's crawling to the bed, crawling. So she doesn't ask, where is my husband? What is So if all of us are walking, there will be nobody looking out for the other.